Hey, what's up, guys? How are you? I want to share with you with one of my recent projects, which is upgrading my bass guitar with a new pickup and new preamp, which I decided I will try to do it by my own at the moment. I don't know what will be the result. However, before finishing it, I want to make a video so we can compare how it sound before and after. So I'm very curious. I hope you will like it. I hope it will be interesting for some of you. So enjoy the video. All right. So a couple of words about the guitar itself. This is a well-known guitar. It's a Sabre 4 series by Sterling, which is a cheaper version of Music Man or Stingray, I believe. And to be honest, I'm very, very satisfied with the guitar itself. It has a very good finish. It's very comfortable. The playing on this guitar is a pleasure. It's very, very good guitar for the money. But I really didn't like two things: the sound of the pickup and the sound of the preamp. So about the guitar, you can check the internet. There are the dozens, hundreds of reviews, so you can check it by yourself. First, I decided to replace the pickup because it was the easy part. I replaced the stock ceramic humbucker with the Alnico Seymour Duncan SMB4A, which I found the easy one to find, and of course, it's not so expensive. This improved the sound a lot. The ceramic pickup was way too loud. The sound was kind of flat, and the Seymour Duncan has this flavor of Stingray sound. The sound is scooped. So you can check my first videos where I use the stock pickup. The sound is tweaked by software and virtual amps. However, it can give you some sample how it may sound. I don't agree that it sounded good. I really didn't like it. There are, of course, some words on the internet that the stock pickup, stock preamp is very good. Leave it, don't move it. Of course, you can leave it, but I'm not the person that if I don't like it, I leave it. I really didn't like the sound, so I decided to do something with that. The pickup is already replaced. And I wired this. I wanted to try this guitar to wire it as a passive bass. So I moved out all the electronics. I replaced the pots with new ones with the better quality. And I did a new wiring and I wanted to try it passive. The effect is quite nice. You will hear it in a minute. I decided that I want to have a preamp in it anyway. So you can go to store and buy a new one. You can order with in some guy which is interested in electronics, but you can try to do it by yourself, which I encourage you because it's kind of fun. I didn't have any experience in electronics, but I think it was a great reason to start with it, to get interested in, to understand how it works, and to try it by myself. So now I will show you how it looks before being installed in the Okay, so this is my guitar. You can see some scratches over here. It's just a normally used guitar. So it's nothing new. Okay, so now you can see how it looks with passive wiring. So yeah, I will move it here. Okay. Yep. Here are the wires that goes to the battery. Yeah, it's a new orange drop on the tone pot. This is how it looks right now when it's wired passive. All right, guys, so this is the preamp.
It's based on the instruction that I found on the internet. You can find by yourself. All the values, all the parts are just the same. The network, the path network, is a little bit different because I had to customize to my size. I wanted to avoid too much cabling. You can see one black cable over here, and this is the ground connection that and as you can see, I had to route my guitar a little bit, not with the sign, but over here. It's just enough. It's not perfect, but okay, come on, it's my guitar. All right. And it fits perfectly. It fits perfectly. Let's see how it will work later. So now the wires are soldered and it's ready to pot installation. So I got three of them. It's 100 kilo ohms. This is for bass. I got it's over here. Yeah, it's 1 mega ohm reversed pot. This will be a treble one, and here is 25 kilo ohms, which will be the volume. Hello everyone. After a couple of weeks, because it was a Christmas time, but now it's done and it's working. It's working, but for the first time when I fired it up, it didn't work. Wow. I wasn't expecting this. It will not work. However, a friend of mine gave me advice how to troubleshoot such things, and he is an expert, so I took his advice. I had to also to fix a path that has been destroyed a little bit during my soldering. So maybe it's not so nice, but it's working. So it's a kind of workaround. Also, this cable over here, it's a VCC. It's a plus from the battery. I forgot to, you know, I missed somewhere to do the output or the input for this input cable, right? So I had to solder it directly to the one of the lugs, whatever. In the meantime, also I had to switch this potentiometer at this pot, as the previous one was destroyed, probably because of the heat. I'm not sure, maybe it's working, but yeah, I just bought a new one. Also, in the previous version that hasn't been working, I mixed some cables over here. I'm very happy with the work. It's a nice adventure, as it is my first such thing, right? So let me present you how it sounds right now in comparison with the passive system within the guitar. Okay, so have fun. Thank you.